Hey folks, so it is freezing cold in Texas. I'm actually using the Dobsonian telescope, and one of the things that I wanted to show everyone is how to use the Dobsonian telescope to take pictures like astrophotography using Dobsonian. I will use the dedicated astronomy camera to connect to the Dobsonian. So to quickly show you where I am with this is a ZWO ASI 294 color camera, okay? So I put a 1.25 adapter in front of it. The 11 is still there, right? The 11mm, the one that comes in the ring, is still there. You just thread the 1.25 adapter here, and pretty much you don't want to use any eyepiece. You just wanted to put that into the 1.25 adapter directly into the Dobsonian. I think that's where you will find the best focus. If you can see barely, this is the focus that is left. So that much inside, you need to send the camera to make sure that you can actually get a good focus. I put a red dot finder, and now the red dot finder is turned on. I know exactly where it is looking at, so I can actually see. Think of the Dobsonian is now looking towards north, right? So I put a mark over here, right? So this particular one that you see here, I put a small tape, and then there is a small line, right? So I need to see the north right there, right? So, and once I do that, right, I move up. This one, this is my north direction, right? So if I move up, I will see the Polaris on the top, and I bring it down. That's my initial home position, all right? And once I put my date, time, and all that stuff, I'm going to select the two-star align. So when you select the two-star alignment, the telescope is going to show you the bright star that is available in your region. If you don't find that star, you can actually change the star to a different one. I use like a cell phone app, like Celestron Sky app, to see if I can actually visually see the object. And if I know where the star is, I will select that star as my first star to align. So the telescope is going to show you the coordinates, but you need to use your hand keyboard to move the telescope to that star, right? And once you see that star in the field of view, on your computer with your camera, right in the middle, then you align it, center it. The second star, the telescope automatically goes to whichever ones that you select and make sure that star is accessible to you before you accepting the second star. And most of the time, the second star won't be there in the field of view. You may be off a little bit here and there, but that's okay. As long as you bring that star to the camera again, to the middle of your screen, right? So that is complete. Once it is successful, if you go to an object, it should track fairly well. If it is not tracking, and if it is moving fast, chances are you may not enter your date or the time incorrectly. Besides the time, make sure, like central time, if I enter the central time, I have to say -6 for the GMT. So make sure you don't ignore that, whatever is the calculation for the GMT, make sure it is correct. Also, you set your latitude and longitude and the elevation correctly. They will save on your telescope. Once you already try that once, it will be there forever. But if those are not correct, chances are the tracking is not good. No, make sure you're already polar aligned by putting the scope there. I think that will give you a pretty good tracking. It is not a perfect science. You still see the object moving away a little bit, but that should be fine. But if it is moving fast enough where you can't take a picture, I think that means something is definitely wrong. You need to go back and try again. I think even though you lose a night, worth trying that multiple times, the polar alignment, the dates and the location and all, and keeping the object in the field of view. If you
get that workflow right, I think that whatever that you just learned is going to save you years of time in the future to come. So I went to the Orion Nebula and I'm surprised to see Orion so bright in the field of view. I'm really impressed by the way it is actually showing. I took the camera out and actually I saw that with my eyepiece. I can notice the color as well. I put the camera back, make sure the focus is fine, and then I started taking like 2 minutes video.